Chocolate Ugly. Good afternoon, heroes and heroines, and welcome to Writing Documentation in English, where we're continuing to document cinema's configuration via this is the configuration, and this is the current state of, I think I can probably do this, yeah. I don't necessarily need to do that actually, but this is the current state of how the help text looks. So you can see that so far we've got the usage, I think at the top. We've got the options, and then we're starting the configuration. And I sort of think that what I'm going to do actually is I'm going to make this its own function, this print config, print print help config. Print out the whole thing. Print help config is just going to be the bit that's about the config, obviously. So yeah, like I say, we've got the usage with the options, and I think we could just keep them together. And just pull this bit out to print config. And the reason for this is that, just turn that off so we get a faster build. The reason for this is, say like the, so that you run the program like the fault like this. Okay, so there is a config. But let's just say that we need to do that. There's no config. Right. Unable to open config file, this. It might be nice if we can't open the config file to just say something like press you know, take input and just like press enter to show the config help, and then it will just show how to actually write a config file. That's basically what I'm thinking of though. So I suppose we could actually just do that, couldn't we? got a config. So yeah, if we got down to here, if we got a config, we could just say here, I would like to actually make it take some input here actually, so that the person can actually see this message. Yeah, there we go. So I guess like, could it get, see? Yeah, it gets a, so it's gonna be the, what does it do? It returns an int to a, it returns the character as an unsigned car, yeah. So F gets C, sticking. What's the difference between F gets C? It reads the next character on the stream returns it as an unsigned car, cast to an int, or end of file. Get C is controlled, so that it may be implemented as a macro, which evaluates the stream more than once. It's equivalent to that, except it may be implemented as a macro. I don't think I care about that. Get car is equivalent to get C standard in. Right. I suppose that. Yes, it's actually if so this this basically means that yes is the default really. So if the input is not no, basically, actually, how do these people actually tend to print the thing? There is nothing to do. Oh. Yeah, it doesn't super matter. I mean, we just print it like that. Print config help, yes or no. Yeah. It might be nice if this is paged as well, actually. Which would mean, think each time you see a new line, you count them up. And once you've reached the actual extent of the terminal, you wait for input. Maybe. Anyway, whatever. So yeah, the first thing we want is the syntax, really. So you've got the configuration. It's like assignments, assigning values. So you want to know how to do that. I might actually do these in sections actually. Do separate printf for each one. Oh, gosh, I shouldn't really show that on stream, should I? No, thank you. Yeah, so run export. Let's declare. Bear with me a sec, I'm just going to put the B of rack screen up. I don't want to really expose sensitive information. I just want to run the export thing and just have a look at it. Particularly sensitive, but I won't show anyway. And I think that running export does show you basically all of the environment variables available to you. So here is where we're going to have some interesting stuff. So here we have these. Ident person, ident project, ident support, ident owner, ident origin, and ident lineage. Okay. Yeah, I mean, I guess it's probably just better to do it manually. Because like I was sort of wondering if you want to sort of have another enum like this that basically sort of says or I suppose, to put it another way, it might even be in here, config identifier strings, making this into a struct and saying, like, whether these things can be local variables. Right. And it's like, if it's a local variable, then XYZ. I mean, you could also have descriptions in here, couldn't you? There was a quick way to do that, but I didn't bother. I guess I should have put false, really. Actually, before I do any of that, let's just fix up the broken code. What we called it. Actually. Yeah, I mean, if I just replace that. It'll warn me, won't it? It's stuff that we can't actually replace. So, where are we? So, push type spec, competition. The ID. So, this type spec. The result. Incompatible types are assigned in type. So config identifier ID. Taking it as a config identifier ID. And the spec field. So we've got spec config type field. Ah. So now we're saying this. Print the text back. Yeah, I think at this point, when we're printing the type spec, I don't think we necessarily care. About whether or not it can be a variable. still happens. How much memory this is using. One point something gig. That's due to the debug information. Alright, so the reason for all of that was so that this config local variables thing could actually print them all out. So basically it would just go over the config identifiers and say, is it a local variable? So what can be a local variable for starters? Right, so hidden lineage can be. Origin. Those are our people that can be local variables. So let's just describe them. The lineage is simply that makes sense. I'll tell you what, actually. Rather than actually saying, rather than having a Boolean, why don't we just say that it's got a description? And if it doesn't have a description, it's not a local variable. That'd probably be the better way of doing it, wouldn't it? Or would it, actually, now I think about it. Yeah, it might not actually. We might want to have descriptions for the non-local variables, actually. Yeah, we probably should, almost definitely will do, actually. So then this person over here goes essentially. I mean, it can be the same thing actually, to be fair. Right, because they have different requirements. Don't they? Like the lineage, definitely derived, yeah, derived lineage of product is something that only happens to that. The origin is something that only, just goes up to the top level parents. And then we've got stuff like the owner, the person, and the project, and the support. I mean, these are kind of similar, actually, aren't they? Right. I mean, if you look at this, actually, the project and the support. Are identical, right? Both warnings. Yeah, those dudes are exactly the same. Now, the person. What is this trying to do? Person. I suppose the person might be different. Hold on a second. Person might be different because you might want to be using the person variable inside of subscope. Like this, so there's a port you would, you know, it can only be within that scope, there's no further subscope you can go. And then the projects, yeah, the project has to be the same scope. Like there's no scopes within the project other than project scopes. So yeah, I can buy that. I can buy that the index, the ident project and the ident support are identical. The ident person I feel like the ident person has to say if we found it, then we do this. Otherwise, you want to get the string. Can do the same thing as this, isn't it? I mean, can't we just say, if the scope ID key is equal to this, right, if this is equal to that, then we can fall through. And it will check it again. But if it isn't, then we set the scope to be equal to the parent scope. Right, and the person is only usable within a person scope and within a support scope. So I feel like if the current scope is not a person, then we need to pop up. Right. And then we should be able to do this check, shouldn't we? Yeah, I do feel like that's just the case. So let's just check scope and scope ID key is equal to variable. And let's just say here, Essentially what I'm saying is if that is not that, then we want to set the scope to be equal to the parent scope. Right. Scrap all of this. Then if we've got scope and the scope and the new scope ID is equal to the variable, then we extend that string in book. Set the result to be that. Otherwise we get our error going. This is a bit different, isn't it? Because that's how to figure out whether they're actually whether the owner exists, and the error is different. We've got the variable cannot be resolved here. Origin. Now again. All we're doing with the origin is getting ourselves up to the person without a parent. If it's not, then it does the error. Right? Same as all of these guys. No, oh, that's the point. Yeah, so you can't actually make these. Yeah, you can't make both of these fall through to the thing. There's that. It does seem to have that actually. I mean, you could do a go to. What's it saying? Lineage. Derive lineage. This is just going up scopes. Maybe I'll just leave that. I'll let the ident person one just go, do this because it's quite a basic thing. The origin is a bit more because it's, you know, it's going up to the top. And then this is driven lineage. Yeah, because it's the thing about these also is that they're not talking about the same identifier as the thing that they're actually wanting to talk about. So we've used the origin variable, but they're actually checking on ident project. Guy gets first. Yeah, so I think these guys could all be the same. Person, project, and support. The K key. Oh, wait a minute, you don't do that, do you? That's the test. Jesus Christ. Yeah. Sorry about that. If that key is not the variable, they pop up. So let's just see what that gives us. Hopefully it's the same. So yeah, what have we actually changed? We've changed the support of the project and the person. So where are we using the project variable? That's what we need to do first. So we're using it here, in the books HTML dir. So where are we? Book. So this is going to propagate down also. So HTML dir. Yeah. It's going to be that, isn't it? Ah, nice one. Multiple registers in the same HTML dir. So yeah, I can't forget, we need to actually put a new line before that. I assume that's what you want. You know, as opposed to making the person previously to actually do the new line. I do like that I've done this though. Multiple projection in the same HTML dir. Yeah, right, so that was just to verify, wasn't it? Let's just verify that. Don't want to print that help. So the HTML dir reader and coad. The other one was person. I used it for myself, didn't I? Yeah, I do. So let's just see what that's looking like. Yeah, home page, that's come through as Nibbler. And URL. Yeah, this one here. So that's the thing, isn't it? And the support was the existing thing. And then up here, I think, didn't use the variable somewhere for the owner, wasn't it? I think this used to say ident owner, but use the variable. So let's just check that's still working. Right, so this is the HTML dir for book. I'm saying, in fact, the HTML dir is probably. They're all probably using the owner. Yeah, so that's popped up there. All right, so I think I haven't broken anything there. Trigger some more errors. So if we just do that. Yeah, I mean, I suppose having the new line before everything isn't such a bad thing, actually. So, all that was to give us the ability to loop over those guys in the local variables printing thing. Right, and we've decided additionally to keep the boolean. So what we're doing is how do we usually loop over these? Oh, it's the array count, isn't it? That's what we usually say. Array count are the config identifiers. Now, what are we saying? We're saying that's null. That's zero. So yeah, that's right. Yeah, if you just do the add and count. Right, that's just the right number, isn't it? What's that saying? Has name ever named a description, doesn't it? Let's go on there. Field ID string. Oh, Jesus. Variable description. Okay, fine. No, fuck that. Because the other thing might actually want a description. That was the thing, wasn't it? Right. Now, additionally, I think I might actually use some colorization. And also you can sort of see, we're getting into a situation here where we need to really, typeset these things. Because it looks fine if you like this, right, if you've got enough space for it. But if you don't, It just splits them in on nice ways. So maybe, I mean, you could sort of hack it to make these descriptions short enough. To fit within like 80 characters. But it's probably worth doing it nicely. Also establish this. So the adding another zero, we do that and then we bump up the indentation level. Okay. So yeah, you do your new line. Verticals. Yeah. Is that what you want? Yeah, I do think it is. Oh, this thing here. In some ways, you want to be able to say, print out this much up to here, and then typeset the rest of this from that level, isn't it? Because we do know that information, don't we? Like, you know where you are in the terminal. Yeah, I don't want to don't want to move it. There's no two ways to get on. Okay. Oh, Jesus Christ, really? I mean, if you can't do it, then you just figure it out yourself, don't you? What's this guy trying to do? All we're trying to do is get the current cursor position. To be deleted, to be deleted. Well, yeah, I mean, if they don't have it, then fine. Well, seems like there isn't really a way to do that, actually. So, whatever. We basically need to say where we are, don't we? Carry on. Yeah, we'll get there. If we need to fancy it up, then we can fancy it up. So we've got a new line. I guess you could also hack it, couldn't you? attack, yeah, you just do that. Or whatever it would be. That's kind of how you do that. Something. Just see what this looks like. If it doesn't look any different. Yeah, it doesn't really. Not exactly sure why that isn't lined up. Because it's intended by the same level. Key, oh, it's these guys, isn't it? Yeah, that'll be it. Right. So the key scope. So, having done this, we want to actually decorate the indentation level. And hang on, actually, yeah, this is going to end the section, so it does the new line. And then we want to decrement the indentation level, indent, and write out variables. Having written out variables, we do a new line. to new section. So we do the new line without bother to indent. Right. Decrement the indentation level. Do this. Don't do that. Do this. Actually, this indented character return business. If you could just pass it like this. Let's try that in a moment. So this is saying to do the amount of variables when it's brought, we want to increment that. You can return it, print the information. Then we want a new line. And then we want to decrement the new line, decrement the indentation level, isn't it? The new line and then increment the indentation level, insert a character return, and then we're going to print the dudes, right? So you print that. That's more reasonable. Oh shit. Yeah, let's do a typeset string function. And all that's going to do is take the string. It's going to essentially do the while characters to write thing. It's going to do all of this. Sort of idea. Except a bit differently, because this one over here is doing it for the config. So the put of this is to typeset pairs, and this is a pair here. And for each thing, it's going to insert the right number of these guys. That's what code return does. But what we're going to be doing is just inserting spaces, indentation basically. And yeah, now that we're doing typesetting, we might as well, well, we've got to talk about the width, the available width. Yeah, right, so if we're going to be talking about indenting this, so we've got a string that's here, we're basically saying typeset this string, and the idea would be that we're going to write as much of this up to the end of a word, up to the, you know, the nearest whole word, and then split the string and start it off again here. That's essentially what we're doing. Yeah, so let's go about that. Type set string. So we're going to say it's taking that string . All we need to determine is whereabouts we are in this string at the moment. Sorry, not in the string. Whereabouts we are in the terminal. Which I was kind of finding out that you can't do, wasn't I? It's not. So the way you'd have to do it, right, we're talking about indenting all typesetting, you know, any of these things really. Know what the indentation level is, right, and we know what the width is, so we could sort of say for each of these things that we're typesetting. Maybe you just pass it in, actually. You know, you say whereabouts you are. It's probably what you do have to do, isn't it, really? The other thing was the getting the width of the terminal, get terminal columns. Okay, so that's the first thing you do. That just does that. Let's have a quick look at this actually. Control the streams, device streams. This, whatever that is. So it's not even in that function. So we know how to get the terminal size. We're in. IO control. Get the consumer phone number. Get to set the window size. Get the window size. That's what we're using. The line discipline of the terminal. Yeah, I can't really see anything appropriate there. Control TTY. Yeah, and I suppose that would be the closest thing, I guess. What we're using. IO control is what we're using. Get keyboard flags. bit promising, isn't it? Fair enough. Let's just say that you can't do it. We have to do it manually. So, get the terminal columns, and we're also saying that we're getting the current column. Right. We're going to pass that in. We want to say the available character is equal to the term columns, take away the current column. We need to write this many characters. So while we've got characters to write, we want to say that the string parent is going to be part. Let me just get it from the other person. Type set parent. Okay, so the value length. So if the do we do that? Do we bother to do that? So if that, then we say the string, the pen, this. Yeah, oh, that's just nab it all. If that, then we're going to set the pen to be this. Take away the characters to write, and the length is going to be equal to the min of the string length and the available characters. Right. Now, having done that, we actually need to determine where the nearest character, where the nearest word break is. So, if the pen B, so the pen dot length take away one. It's not a new a space. Then we need to say Well, I guess you could also sort of say, while the panda is not yeah, I mean, you could have a thing where there's got no spaces. In which case, you just split that where you can do. So there's your pen. I think we could do with another pen, actually. Oh, unless we don't modify the pen length, actually. Yeah, so while it's greater than zero, okay, and having done that, if the length is now greater than zero, we set that pen length to be the length. Right. And then we print that amount. This takes something to, we decorate that by the pen length, and then while we store characters to write, we do our indented carriage return. Well, it's kind of like a carriage return, and then print out the number of the current columns, isn't it? Characters in key plus delimiter. Oh, it's the that's another thing, isn't it? So I think we just do that. Set this to be that. So actually, that's not the right place to do that. You do the pen first. Okay, so let's actually call it typeset string. So, yeah, indented card return. We're saying to type, think of it this. The string probably we don't need to bother with, but the description do. This value is going to be the indent width as well the indentation level. So let's see if this does anything good for us. Hopefully we should see that the lineage gets split. Oh, also we don't need to. We can omit the space, so I think we've probably got one thing a bit wrong at the moment. But we'll get there. Should split that there, and we should hopefully get family lining up with the A. It's probably going to be a space off, actually. This should split. This should line up with the there. And then hopefully this guy, we should have splitting before the O and printing out. Over there, so let's see what we get. Here we get all of that. Now, that's got itself a bit confused. So let's just see why that might be. The available characters is always the same. Let's just fix the space issue for starters. So we're going to we're determining the length of this thing. So yeah, while length is going to 0, and while that is not a space. Decrement that. Once it is a space, then we want to the length is greater than that. And the pen base well actually let's do it internally if if we're on a space, we want to say, we want to decrement the length, further space, and say if the length isn't greater than 0, then we haven't split the space. Right. So, do those characters to write is going to be less than or equal to the pen length. Right. So we've written out that many characters. We could then say, if we split it to space, we don't need to write another character. So like decrement do that a bit more explicitly. Right. So then while the character's to write is greater than zero, we need to dig a new line in the spaces. We set up the string. The length is that. Decrement the length, and then again, split it. I think we just do the same deal, don't we? Print the string, and then having done that, decrement the characters to write. If we split the space, we decrement that further. I'm not sure if this would help us with this though. Yeah. The available characters is equal to the get term of columns take with the current column. Characters to write is equal to the string length. Should it be actually do something about that? Oh no, because the character string is always going to be the same. Like by the end of it, you have to have written out the entire string. Let's step through it. See what it thinks we're trying to do. Slash separated string above product IDs from the top of the product tree to the present product is length 98 apparently. Oh shit, yeah, this guy is actually not going to be able to do it. Because this get term of columns is going to be nothing. So the available column is going to be minus number, yeah. Obviously that's 16. Yeah, so that ain't gonna help us. Tell you what, I might just say that the get term of columns is gonna be 80. Right, I think there's possibly 80 characters available here. Well, let's just say it's 64 or something. simply because inside this it just doesn't let you do that. Alright. So now we've got 48 columns to play with. And the string was how long? 98 length. So that means that we should need 3 lines for that, doesn't it? Alright. So that reckons 48. And now also it's looking the same. We need to take some of this. I guess there's 98 characters. We're saying we can print out 48. So that put us there. So we might be able to write the entire basically. I think that would include the France, by the way. It shouldn't, this shouldn't pass. Don't think. Actually, let's just see where we are actually. Yeah, it's on the M. Hang on. Length takeaway 1. Yeah, we should be able to write this, shouldn't we? If I'm not mistaken. You know, if you've got 48 characters to play with, okay, yeah, it sort of seems like we want to have to be testing the character after, doesn't it? Well, the length is greater than 0, and the length is also less than the actual string length. Is not a space, then we want to decrement the length. Now, if the length is 0, and if we say that the if I've done this. The base length. We decorated the length. The length is greater than 0, and the length is less than the string length. And the pen that place of length is less is not equal to the space. This doesn't it? If the length is this, either way, we want to Someone set the pen length to be equal to the length, I think. And if the length, again, it's the, if the length is, hang on. It's something to do with the characters to write, isn't it, actually? I think it's that. Let's try this. So my theory is that this should fail. What we're looking for. Right, that is a space. So that should fail, right? So yeah, we should have detected that we're splitting our space. Decremented that length and splitting the space. So yeah. Our slash separated all, oh hang on a minute. Shouldn't that have printed a bit more? If we, hang on. If the length, the character after us. Is space. Yeah, I think that this ain't correct. Yeah, okay, so we got the from. If we split it the space, then we need to decorate the characters to right. Okay. So the characters to right is greater than that. Should be, shouldn't it? Yeah. So you print if you new line. and you do your spaces to the current column. No. From the top of the family teacher, the present project. Oh, I need to change those guys. This is the wow, yeah. So I think this might be a bit more like it. So this is a string or project ID is from. Really? Present project, possibly. Okay, so it's just sticking project on the bottom, on the next line. And then we're done. So if I'm not mistaken, that would have looked at correct. Yeah, they're all good. They're all correct. So let's just take a look at the actual print typeset pair function. It prints the copy identifier in yellow bold. So let's just do that for the lineage. Oh, right. Yeah, now that we've done that, we should be able to also say the following. Right. Get this thing to split. That automatically. Let's just try it. So you want to be talking about writing out this much information. What should we say? Yeah, writing out this much information. And then type setting the rest of it. Right. And what this would essentially amount to would be like int column. Basically that. Oh, that didn't fancy it, did it? Need to actually factor in the indentation. Might colorize these actually. True, 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 yes. Although, could that throw off the actual length of the string? Yeah, it might, mightn't it? I think. Not fret about that too much. Actually, the thing is, though, if you do the fprintf, I think, like, if I do this. That's going to throw the thing off. It's a bit, oh, right. Yeah, you see that? It hasn't been able to tell me that it isn't actually that that far. So yeah, it just gets confused. And this is what I don't like about fprintf. So it says in the documentation, upon successful return, these functions return the number of characters printed. Right. So you would have thought, wouldn't you? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 characters. You would have thought that would count as 15 characters. But it doesn't. It counts as, it includes the colour strings. Yeah, I mean, I guess that's possibly fair enough, actually. It has to go somewhere. I guess fprintf doesn't necessarily need to be able to know about the escape codes. But there was another thing about the, oh right, yes, yeah, it's the Unicode characters. So if you print a Unicode character, it doesn't actually know about Unicode. That's the thing. So you print a single Unicode character that's like 4 bytes. It counts that as 4 bytes long when it should really be 1 byte, I suggest. Yeah, I mean, you could hack it, couldn't you? By doing the following. prepare take. That takes a conflict pair, delivered to an indentation and an append new line. Did all that. A config pair is a key and a value. Yeah. So hopefully that's sensible. Yeah, to environment variables. What color should we do these? Cyan, let's do cyan. So actually, let's just have a quick gander at so that does include the int, I think. Yeah, so they look the same. The project and the home gets the same thing. Yeah, fine. sort of seems like. Oh, yeah, it's just the column, isn't it? Types of string is the column. Do I do that? So this is a section, right? And it's almost like open section. And you're sort of saying, this is a configuration section. Increment the indentation level is what you do when you do that. And each time you open a new section, you want to have a new line before the section starts. Let's just do that, open section. It's like an indented code return, isn't it, really? Let's say that there isn't a space actually after we open the thing. So we do that, we do the indentation level. And then we do an indented code return. Right. And then the next person is just ready to do the whatever it is. All right. So basically what I'm saying is new section, configuration. And you're just going to be forever sort of saying that the column is equal to the indent dengarajig times the indentation level. Which seems like a bit of a nightmare, doesn't it? Yeah, although it's assigning value to this section also, isn't it? Let's see what this does for us, if anything. So yeah, still looks fine. So the new section configuration, so many values. And sort of end section is going to just decorate it into so sending there's so end yeah end section you simply want to say this. Alright, then here we've got another section. So we want to end that section and start a new section. typeset that string. Rewrite variables on the 6th residential, gosh. Then we just wanted to do this for some reason. I suppose you could say is a section without a thing. Couldn't you? So yeah, config set, so assigning values, do keystring, right. I reckon before we do the variables printout, I think we want to actually do the what do you call them? The keys, basically. Now, obviously, assigning values. where we've done this. That was the wrong bit. What's it here? So you need to know how to assign things. String, number, bool, scope. And the available keys that we've got. Essentially this. Right. This title is, and we still don't really know about this. I do also feel inclined to reorder these things. So yeah, we've got the bears first, then the bools, then the numbers, then the scopes, then the strings. I'm inclined to say that we don't do like that. We push them on. First, the strings. Yeah, we still have to tell this stuff. I'm gonna keep it for now. But yeah, basically I'm still saying. Yeah, the stuff that pushed onto the roots, it's these things here. Let's push the strings first. Then let's push the numbers. That might be the fine order actually to put them. And then a similar deal with the projects. Push the strings on first. And the scopes last, I reckon. So you got the strings bare boolean, number scope, bare boolean, number scope, bare boolean, scope. So there's no numbers for the projects, is there? It's So yeah, we could colorize this the same as this, right? So people know what they're talking about. Suspicious. So we've got a scion down here. We're saying init type specs and then print type specs. Right. For the whole lot, print the type spec. And then it's supposed to do this. It looks like we're getting this though. Where's that happening? That's happening here. Config identifier string. That's happening there. So yeah, there's no ID, is that right? Yeah, I guess it is, isn't it? So really we want to be saying, but also we do want to factor in the stuff about the columns and the indentation. Yeah, which again is tricky when you, well, you need to just compute the length beforehand. Well, hold on a second, why don't we just do print string? Print C, isn't it? Then, so we've got the config identifiers. I think what we want to do is actually describe what they're doing. Yeah, so that's something we'll need to do. Settings. Yeah, we haven't got any information like this, including. Done 3 hours. So I think we're going to take a break. Get some lunch or get some dinner or whatever I fancy. And then I suppose I'll continue another day. There was another thing actually, wasn't there? Just before I go. What was this? So yeah, when I started the stream, my cursor was sat somewhere in Sinnoh.c. Let's see if I get back to where that might have been. It's a very tiny thing that I spotted. Ah, it's not letting me go back further. So quick look at the video. Ah, that was it, the roll strings. Yeah, perfect. It was just this, because we basically re-specified it as not having the hyphen. That's it. 3 hours. Call it a day. So, yep, until next time. Suppose a good wait a minute to get around 3 hours. Feel I could do that. Miscellaneous section was pretty important. Telling people that you can do the comments, telling people you can skip projects. Yeah. All right, let's call it there. And next time I will see you. So until then, farewell for now.